It is the Indigenous Australians living, working, classic great Australian lives who are completely disinterested in this stuff. They know that big government delivers nothing. They know it's all ideology, left-wing ideology. One of those who was a strong supporter of The Voice, in fact, she claimed to be untethered when she heard the results of The Voice.
Untethered.
Oh. That's another word for unhinged, perhaps. There are many synonyms for untethered. Disconnected from reality would be another one. They've picked her as our new Governor General. I'll be talking about this appropriately in Clown Show later on in the show today. But Sam Mostyn was Albanese's pick for the new Governor General, James. My thoughts?
Well, I mean, I've got a few thoughts, and I know you'll be covering this a bit later on in the program, Rob, but let me just say that I think that it is absolutely remarkable that we now essentially have the Governor General for Human Resources here in this very high office of the land. It's really remarkable to me a couple of things, though. They've broken the mold of Governor Generals and now said that essentially this path of going through corporate boardrooms and being involved with diversity efforts and lobbying for political things and being a Labor staffer, this well-worn path, and we all know tons of people in places like Sydney and Melbourne who've done this, you know, this is now not being a general, not a life of public service, this is the way to the highest office of the land, which we honor. And I'll say one last thing. We are heading potentially towards a hung parliament at the next election. The advice of the Governor General will be crucial. It is absolutely crucial that that office be held by someone who is seen to be above the political fray. And I'm afraid that is not Sam Mostyn.
An advisor to the Teals, Rita.
A former Labor staffer, someone who has been a leftist activist across the board, whether it's global warming, whether it's gender quotas, whether it's The Voice, who has been so political, always on the left. If you want her to be apolitical, then good luck. And the mere fact that upon getting this honour, she wiped her social media footprint.
Yes.
She went to Twitter or X, as we call it, and wiped her account and whatever has been posted there. Obviously, some of those tweets have...
Some have surfaced.
Yes. And they tell you, you know, she's using hashtags like always was, always will be. She's using hashtags like Invasion Day. This is not someone who is has mainstream, Australian.
And of course, there's always the classic irony that although she's not explicitly been a Republican, her sympathies have clearly been with the Republican movement. She worked with Paul Keating. She's now the Governor General. Is just laughable.
Well, one other thing, too, is, you know, I have spoken to MPs on both sides of politics about this, and there are some Labor MPs out there who are not thrilled with this choice at all, including one who said that this person had a career in essentially corporate greenwashing and that they were somebody that big companies would put on their boards to create this sort of impression that they're doing diversity and inclusion while, in fact, you know, they're doing all the other things that they do.
This is something Janet Albrechtson wrote a brilliant column about throughout the week, about how there's this select group of women who put themselves or get on elected to boards and they're very carefully guard that those positions. There's a very small number, but it gives the corporates a way to say, oh, look at our board, look at the diversity and the gender targets we're meeting. So it's something that serves them well. Whether it serves the sisterhood well is another question entirely.
Whether it serves Australia well is another question
Well, that's, I think, obvious.